Julie, commence Operation Winged Freedom! Bring the, thing. Check out my latest invention. An airbender finder.
Wait, that can find airbenders?
I think it's broken.
It's not broken. She needs to airbend into it. How else do you expect the thing to work?
Honesty is for fools, kid.
Derek?
If you want to ditch this girl, then make yourself scarce. Disappear like I did.
Where are you?
Somewhere Unalaq will never find me. Inside Ping Ping! How are we doing?
The coast is clear. You can come out.
No way, mister. Not until I know it's absolutely 157% safe.
Ah, thank you, Julie.
Your assistant's in there, too?
Julie never leaves my side. You forgot the honey!
Sorry, sir. There isn't any in here.
No honey? We're in a bear, for crying out loud! It worked! Julie, mark it down. Magnet suit test successful. Power down. On to phase two. Julie cleans up this mess. Idea Storm, get the supplies.
You're about to get an inside look at how Varric Global Industries stays at the forefront of imagination innovation, or imagivation. That's trademarked, pal. Brain work requires increased circulation.
Let's do this!
Here come the ideas. Fast and furious. Pink, mint, lemon, tea. Radio for pets. Hand shoes.
Hold on a tick. We don't need the president to go to the South. We just need the troops. Let's go straight to them.
If there's one thing I know about troops, it's that they love fighting.
I know General Iroh. He might be willing to help us.
A man on the inside. Perfect. And you need to sell some mecha tanks. I know some people who need them. We'll ship them south.
That's perfect. You'll be making money for your company, and you'll be helping to defeat Unalaq.
It's true. If you can't make money during a war, you just flat out cannot make money.
It's dangerous on the seas right now, but I'm willing to try if you are.
It'll be crazy risky.
But I love crazy risky! End storm!
Julie, get those other ideas to research and development. I want prototypes by next week.
I don't understand why it's so hard to get Republic City to support the South.
Don't worry. I'm already working on that. As soon as people see this, they'll be lining up to fight Unalaq. Julie, do the thing.
I gotta go to work.
I better go check on my factory.
I'm going to find out about this peace march.
And I am dying for a pedicure.
You have a license for that animal?
You fellas seen a traveling circus come through here?
Julie, do the thing.
That platypus bear is pooping money!
Where's your dad?
On a ship headed north. Think we can catch up to it?
Sure, once you get us past our friends from the north.
If only we had a plane to get me close to those ships, I could waterbend them out of the way.
A plane? Well, why didn't you say so?
Why do you have a plane on your boat?
In case the boat sinks, of course.
But there's no runway. How are we supposed to take off?
Julie! Take a note. Build runway.
Yes, sir.
Guys, hey! What do you think?
Varric Industries built this prison, and I had this cell made special. I had a feeling I'd end up here one day. Julie, come on! We got guests! Whip up a pot of that green tea I love!
Yes, sir.
Julie's in prison with you?
Of course. I don't go anywhere without my assistant. Do you?
We're not interested in your tea, and this isn't a friendly visit.
Don't tell me you guys are still mad about everything that happened. I did some good things, too. Cora, who warned you about Unalaq? I did. Bolin, who got you into the movers? I did. Asami, who saved your company? I did. Mako, who got you thrown in jail? I did. Oh yeah, I guess that was a bad thing.
You stole everything from me, and you tried to kidnap the president. Those are pretty bad, too.
I wasn't going to hurt him. I just needed to start a war. Well, a bigger war.
Well, we're gonna end it. Where's all the stuff you stole from Asami?
The future industry stuff? It's on my battleship.
You have a battleship?
Of course I do! I bought the first one they made! Named her the Julie.
You named your battleship after your assistant?
Yep. They're both cold, heartless war machines.
Your tea, sir.
Look, I am truly sorry for the mess I caused. Let me make it up to you. Take Julie. My battleship. It's yours, and everything on it.
It's not the fleet we were looking for, but it's the next best thing.
All right! Team Avatar is back in business!
Hey, Varric! What are you doing here?
Collecting pumice stones with Julie. That lava bender did a lot of damage, but he makes a nice exfoliating rock. And when you got calluses like mine, you take all the pumice stones you can get your hands on. Or in my case, feet!
Varric, another one of your ships has been captured.
Darn it, Julie! Haven't I told you I hate getting bad news without first getting good news?
Well, the good news is it looks like your first mover has gotten a great reception.
That's old news! Let's go. Get over here and pop a squat. Julie, get some tea for my guests.
Thank you for meeting with me. As you know, Future Industries is looking for a partner to handle our shipping.
Sure, but first, you gotta check out my new venture. Moving pictures. Julie, do the thing. You're gonna love this. Mind-blowing, right?
Yeah.
Now, forget that! That's the past! Shut it off, Julie! Imagine watching this. Ginger, come over here. Do your poses. Spectacular! And we tell a story. There's romance, action, some funny animal stuff for the kids, you know, whatever. Thanks, Ginger. Go rest your games. How about that, Tiger Shark? We're gonna do big business with these movers, as I call them.
Okay, but I'm just concentrating on getting Future Industries back on track. If we could hammer out a deal.
Stop. Look me in the eye. We got a deal! We'll hammer out the details at the Royal Feast tonight. Now, who wants a rocket boat ride?
Is that how business usually goes?
You are a natural assistant.
Never thought I'd be allowed back in the Republic City Four Elements. Raiko must have turned purple when Kuvira made him pardon me of my alleged crimes.
You're an upstanding citizen again, sir.
Upstanding is right!
Don't forget to fill the extra bag with as many of those little soaps as you can grab. Love the lavender scent.
Cut! There's no kiss in the script.
Sorry, I just kind of lost myself in the moment. It just felt so right.
It did, huh? Your girlfriend's about to die, and instead of untying her, you kiss her. Wait a minute! Maybe that will work! Yes! It's genius! Everybody take five! Except for you, Julie. Grab the tweezers. I've got some neck hair issues to resolve. Troubling? Troubling is when I get that itchy rash that won't go away and Julie's not around to scratch it. This is shocking. Nay, sickening. But these kale cookies? Opposite. Remind me to get the recipe later.
What's your point, Varric?
My point is, Unalaq's already booted our chieftains out of their palace. How long before he starts telling us what kind of cookies we can eat?
Probably a couple of days.
Rhetorical question, Julie. You gotta keep up. Not to mention, I've got a cargo ship full of halibut that's rotting thanks to this harbor lockdown. Who wants to buy a ship full of stinking fish? Seriously, it's not rhetorical. I need to sell these fish.
Chief Unalaq is here to help the South. He wants to show us how to restore balance with the spirits so they'll stop attacking.
The only spirit I'm interested in restoring is our spirit of independence! Am I right, people?
Yes!
All Unalaq is trying to do is make our tribes unified again.
No, he wants control of our wealth. My wealth. And I like my wealth! If Unalaq doesn't pull his forces out, then we have no choice but to fight for our freedom!
You want to start a war? Are you crazy?
Unalaq started this, not us. I'm sorry. Maybe you could speak with your uncle. Tell him how frustrated we all are. He'll listen to what the Avatar has to say. Do it for me.
I'll do it for the tribe.
I cannot stop eating these things.
Weld hotter, tighten tighter. The president said we only have 2 weeks to get these hummingbirds humming.
Varric, good, you're here. Can I talk to you for a minute?
What is it? I'm busy inspiring my workers.
Well, I went to Zhaofu and saved Sue and her family, and guess who else we found?
Ha!
Julie.
Now, isn't there something you wanted to say to her?
Please, let me go first. I know I said a lot of terrible things about you in front of Kuvira, but I need you to know, I didn't mean one word. When you were being taken away, I thought my only chance to save you was to join her. But every day I hoped for the chance to see you again and tell you the truth. Varric, you mean the world to me, and I'm sorry if I hurt you in any way.
Don't be so hard on yourself.
Apology accepted! Now be a good assistant and man the assembly line!
No! I am not your assistant anymore! If you want me around, you need to start treating me like an equal!
Julie, I've been thinking.
You're always thinking, sir.
Yes, but lately I've been thinking about you. I know we might not make it out of this mess, and I feel like there are some things I should tell you.
There are?
I remember when I was a boy, I had an ostrich horse. Named her Mrs. Beaks. I grew up on a farm, did I ever tell you that, Julie? This was before the circus people took me away. Anyway, I loved old Mrs. Beaks, but I took her for granted.
You'll have to finish your story later. Kuvira's troops are in range. Okay. This works.
Yes! Dead in their tracks! Oh, rats! She's still coming! Julie, do the thing!
I'm afraid there are no more things to do.
Julie?
Yes?
I have something I need to attach before we take off.
Attach to what?
I need to attach this ring to your finger. Julie Moon, will you do the thing for the rest of our lives?
Yes.
Yes! Mwah!
Now let's go attach these barely functional rust buckets to a giant killer smashing machine!
It's exactly how I always pictured our engagement.
So that is why, dearest friends and family, we gather today to celebrate the wondrous and at times inexplicable bond between Sir Varric and the Lady Julie!
Hey, pal! Camera on me! This is my big day!
True love is a fickle creature, difficult to find, nearly impossible to tame. But Varric and Julie have proven that even the longest of long shots can have a chance at happiness together. Now for the vows. Thank you, Mr. Pabu. Do you, Sir Ichnik Blackstone Varric, of the Southern Water Tribe, Master of the High Seas, take the Lady Julie Moon to be your lawfully wedded wife? Will you promise to treat her not as your assistant, but as your honored
and cherished partner.
You're darn tootin', I do!
And do you, Julie, take Varric to be your lawfully wedded husband. Do you promise to care for him in sickness and in health, and also scrub his calluses on a bi-weekly basis, which isn't really that much to ask. Okay, I'm not reading all this.
I do take Varric, calluses and all.
You may now do the thing.
Oh!
Are you all right?
You just make me so dang happy.